And now we will learn how to make invoices from the estimates we just created. The estimate is the main contract, and as you make progress during the contract, you will send an invoice to your client for the progress you made from the main contract estimate. The estimates versus actual detail report shows the estimates compared to the invoices of those estimates. That's the one we're going to look at after we record our first example invoice. For example, January 3, we made invoice number 1 for the Hanson Place job under Brown Company. On that invoice, we're billing the customer for 5 units of carpentry, 5 units of electrical work, 5 units of replacement parts, and 5 units of steam cleaning. Notice the price for each item is the same as what it was on the estimate. So let's take a look at how to record it. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Invoice. Now, you should change the invoice number to invoice number 1. That's what would happen normally. It's only coming up as number 2 because I was practicing with this file before the video. Move the date forward or backward, depending on when you're watching the video, to January 3 of 2017. Now look what happens at the moment that you choose the Hanson Place job. You get a pop-up message telling you that the Hanson Place job has available estimates. This pop-up is a normal part of the process, and it's helping you match this invoice to estimate number 1. Normally there would be a list of several estimates, but in this case there's only 1, so we have to click on it to select it. When we click OK, all of the information from estimate number 1 will go here on invoice number 1. The only thing you have to do is adjust the quantity of each item to make sure that we're billing the customer on January 3 of 2017, specifically for only the items that we have given. We've only given 5 of each item and not 25, so after the information got copied from the estimate onto the invoice, we adjust the quantity. QuickBooks will recalculate the money amount for the amount that we're billing the customer on January 3rd. When we click Save and Close, we can check the results in the reports. Click Report, Jobs Time and Mileage, Job Estimates versus Actual Detail. Click it, and then make sure you choose the correct customer, or the correct job, in this case Hanson Place. Click OK, and as you can see, the estimated income was the total of each item, and the actual are the amounts that we actually bill them for on the invoice. These would be 25 of each item, and we only bill them for 5. So it's currently showing you the difference between what was billed and what was estimated in the first place. This report does not consider any possible future invoices that might occur. Now it's important that you see a second example of a second invoice from the same estimate. Let's imagine on January 6, we made another invoice for the Hanson Place job under Brown Company. Now again, on January 6, we're billing them for an additional 5 units out of the 25 units on the original estimate. Let's take a look at what happens. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Invoice. Since you will use invoices all the time, it might be a good idea to pin up the invoice in the icon bar. Click View, Add Create Invoice to the icon bar, and click OK. Now it will be more convenient for you and you won't have to struggle to remember where to click. We open the invoice window and we move the date forward to January 6th of 2017. Notice QuickBooks knows that this is the second invoice in this file, and you could always change the number to anything you need it to be. But look what happens at the moment we choose the Brown Company Hanson Place job. The same pop-up occurs. This is the only estimate to choose, so we're going to click on it. Then when we click OK, notice QuickBooks does not adjust the quantity for the remaining items. All QuickBooks is going to do is copy whatever's on the estimate onto the invoice. It doesn't even matter that we used some of these in a previous invoice. When we change every quantity to 5, because again, we're only billing them for an additional 5 items out of the entire 25 on the estimate, just 3 days later, on January 6th, you have to be careful, it's going to pop the date and invoice number back to what they were. So, let's make sure that the invoice looks the way we need it to look, and then we click Save and Close. When we reopen the report for job estimates versus actual detail, and we choose the correct job and click OK, notice the actual revenue went up. It's not the same as the estimated revenue, but you can tell mathematically this is 10 out of the 25 items have been billed. So QuickBooks considers the actual revenue only that which was billed and put on an invoice, and the estimated was put on the estimate. And QuickBooks assumes you earned this because you put it on an invoice and gave it to the customer. I'd also like to mention that I am not going to put this report up in the icon bar because this report is specific customer by customer and job by job. And we will not have enough room in the icon bar for this report for every job. As soon as we turn on progress invoicing in the next video, there will be no need for this report because the progress invoice reports are much better.